You didn't forget what the dress code was. Why not?
Hello, everyone. Thank you for coming. On behalf of my family, I'd first like to express my immense gratitude to all friends, family, and loved ones who have reached out to support my family and myself during these hard times. Though we may well never be able to fully recover from this tragedy, the kind words and outreach from this community have helped my family greatly and are a testament to how much joy meant to so many people. Also, before I begin, I'd like to apologize in advance for any loss of composure. If I start to tear up and eat my words during the speech, and you find you have no idea what I'm saying, please just nod and pretend I'm making sense. That would be greatly appreciated. First of all, I would like to welcome you all on my behalf to the inaugural celebration of the life of Clay Sober, an annual celebration for a life-changing man. Today is not a day to mourn, but instead to celebrate how lucky we all are to have had the honor of even the smallest amount of time with my beloved brother. And also to thank each and every one of you who have made my brother's life as special as it was. To all who knew Clay, he was not a man to dwell on the bad parts of life, but instead only to move on to what positive aspects can be taken from. My goal by the end of the service is not to have all of you feel sorrow for the fact that Clay was ripped from our lives too soon, but instead to remember the greatest parts of Clay and how we can all take positives from this sad event. So on behalf of my late brother, I say, "Hola, future homies." Thank you for coming. Clay's been an important part of my life from the day I was born. As early as 1 year old, Clay can be seen caring for me and giving me love. He never let me feel inferior to him and took a backseat on many things when we were children so that I could learn from him. He has cared for me in times of need, showed me the right path in life, and helped me become the man that I am today. What I most remember Clay for is not for doing what big brothers are supposed to do, but instead going above and beyond. What made Clay special to me was the fact that he was more than just a big brother. He was the best friend. Clay is a man I could talk to whenever, a straight shooter that I could always look to when I needed help. It didn't matter if it was 2 in the morning or 5 in the afternoon. If I needed Clay, he was always there for me. When he was off in college, there would never be a day when I didn't get a text from Clay saying how he was thinking of me, or how he couldn't wait to see me, or even a simple hello. I always enjoyed any text I got from Clay, because when you grow up with a brother as loud, clumsy, and bashful as him, things get very quiet in his talk. We would talk for hours about the dumbest of stuff. Whether it was about how he won money on a lottery ticket, or how he was destined to live on his couch for 20 years. We would talk about plans for the future, and how we would both be a part of each other. These things did wonders for my confidence, and I cannot thank him enough for that. What I hope all of you can understand is that there's one part of my life that I would never sacrifice for all the money, speech, and power in the world. It would be my childhood with my brother. I hope that he continues to embody his integrity and loving character throughout the coming years in order to keep his ideals alive. Just as Clay was a role model, I will be a role model. Just as Clay was gracious, I will be gracious. Lastly and most importantly, just as Clay rocked a dad bod, I was a big brother. I would like to switch gears now and talk about Clay's friends and family affected him during his life. Now, as many of you know, Clay was about as social as a man could be. He He very seldom was alone, and when these times came about, I can assure you Clay was not happy about it. Deep down, Clay was a man who needed companionship. He was a socialite who was always trying to impress and interest anyone who listened. Anytime Clay could make someone laugh, smile, or even listen to his band, he felt as happy as he could be. I believe that Clay was able to every day fully enjoy his life because of the loving and caring group of friends that he surrounded himself with. I cannot thank you all enough for what you all have done for him. Even those minor connections with Clay meant the world to him, and every conversation Clay had with one of his friends was cherished. This goes all the way back to his days as an aide. When we were very young, both Clay and I attended the Children's Home School in Winchester for pre-K and kindergarten. This was Clay's first experience in socializing, and for the person Clay was when he died, I'm certain it was a good one. To all friends of Clay's at COS, I would like to thank you. You laid the groundwork for who Clay became. From COS, Clay moved on through the Winchester school system. From Lincoln, through Minton McCall, and then to WHS. Each school poses its own challenges. Whether it's meeting a new whole classroom at Lincoln, dealing with life looking like a gigantor after growing to 5'8" by 6th grade and having a face that looked like the Himalayan mountain range, or just trying to get into college. Through the immense support shown by Clay's friends throughout those years, he was able to look back on them with nothing but happiness. And once again, I thank you for that. To all people who coached or participated on the same team as Clay, you also deserve to be thanked. Clay didn't always love the sport he was playing, but I can assure you that he always loved the people. To all Clay's in summer, friends in summer, or as we call them, BT, I thank you. You guys became some of Clay's best friends in no time at all, and in the end, Clay died doing what he loved. Now is having a good time with you all. Last but not least, I would like to thank everyone at the University of Denver who welcomed Clay and accepted him. To Sigma Chi, Clay considered you all brothers, and not just in the Greek sense. His best times were out there, and he loved each and every one of them. To anyone I have not mentioned, I thank you as well. The hardest thing for me and my brother's passing was the thought of never speaking to him again. I had so much to tell him and hear from him, and now that he's gone, I'll never have a chance. Due to this, I've written a short letter to Clay which details the last things I need him to know. So here it goes. Dear Clay, I'm sorry. I'm sorry I never told you how much you meant to me. I'm sorry I was never thankful enough for the things you did. I'm sorry for all the times I was unfair, unjust, or mean to you. And I'm sorry that I never told you I loved you. When you expect to see your brother every day for the rest of your life, you don't think to tell him how great he is. I want you to know how great you were. You meant so much to me. You were my mentor, friend, fan, and hater, and I love you for it. Who I am today is a reflection of you and all your teachings. I miss you. Sometimes I wake up in the middle of the night in a cold sweat, and I can't help myself but weep the good times we had and the soon to be great times we're taking from us. I want you to know that I'll become a better person for you. Every goal I set will be in your name. Every laugh I have will be in your memory. I will fight my hardest to get to the place in life that you always said I was destined to arrive at. To give up on my dreams and ambitions will be an insult to your name. I want you to know how much you meant to your friends. In these past few days, I have not been alone. Your friends have stood by me just as they have stood by you. They have cried for you, laughed for you, and reminisced about you. And I want you to know that each and every one of them has had their life changed in your presence. Last thing I need you to know, Clay, is that I thank you. I'll never be able to say this enough, but your presence on this earth was a blessing. You leave this world leaving a mark, and that mark is that you are the most amazing man who has done so much for so many people. I love you, bro. BT for life, Doc Boys for life, best friends for life. I'll see you soon, and I can't wait to hear what you need to create for yourself up there. Love, Tim. Now, all the time, guys, so. Last thing I'd like to do is meet Paul. This Paul has been part of my family for a long time. It was my grandfather's favorite poem, and it was something that we read at his funeral. And I think that it should be read at my brother's as well. The name of the poem is Crossing the Bar by Alfred Lord Tennyson. Sunset, evening star, and what did you call for me? And may there be no moaning of the bar when I head out to sea. But such a tide is moving seems asleep, too full for sounding foam, when that which drew from the boundless deep turns again to home. Twilight, evening bell, and after that the dark. And may there be no end of sadness or farewell when I embark. For though from out are born of time and place, the flood may bear me far. I hope to see my pilot face to face when I cross the bar.